I'm participating on a panel of largely analysts and then myself. Can't exactly call myself an analyst, but you know, basically observers of the television ecosystem and observers of what's happening with the onslaught of digital, the consumer changes, and some of the business model changes. So we're giving the sort of Wall Street perspective or the investor perspective, because if you think about it, you've got very different types of companies, right? You've got at least three categories I can think of where it matters to Wall Street investors. You've got the traditional TV companies, both the distribution and the content companies, that clearly their futures are going to be significantly impacted, and when I say their futures, also their stock prices, are going to be impacted by how TV evolves and how it converges with digital. You've got the tech companies and the big players in tech and telco arena that are looking at this as an opportunity to invest and expand their services in a digitally delivered television world as opposed to the more traditional linear. And then, quite frankly, there's everyone else. There's the measurement companies like Nielsen and like Comscore and all the, let's not forget, all the technology startups that are finding solutions to how they think what will be needed in an audience-based, people-based TV buying world. If you were to take a look at the marketing technology ecosystem broadly defined, it's a tale of two cities, right? You've got, at one hand, you know, fantastical exits at great multiples as new strategic players enter the marketplace, witness some of the telcos just in the last year that you and I have talked about, Verizon, Comcast, Telenor, Singtel. So there's been a lot of activity in terms of new entrants. Of course, the usual suspects, the big guys that are in the space now, have to be mindful what to do. News Corp bought a capability last year in native video. There's a lot of people sort of that are lining up the capabilities necessary to sort of win in this converged world. At the same time, you know, investors are down on the space in general. Public market valuations are at an all-time low. Some of these companies are trading at a fraction of less than a quarter of one turn of revenue. So clearly there's this, you know, bifurcation. And I think there are some concerns in the marketplace around competition with giants like Google and Facebook. But I think there, for differentiated quality companies, there will be real opportunities to both grow their business and then potentially to exit as the strategics line up their needs to win. There's a disparity right now between public and private valuations. Nobody would sell their business for 0.2 times revenue. That said, so long as that persists, that will over time start to affect private valuations. And I would say a bigger determinant to private valuations has occurred just in the last 6 months, as we've seen a tech pullback in terms of the veracity to fund startups, and it's just had an implication on exit prices for many. Let's remember that, you know, of 100 companies in the space, you know, 95 will have issues, 5 will get exits of quality.